accept your nomination for President of the United States.
47% of the people who will vote for the President no matter what. All right, there are 47% who are with him, who are dependent upon government, who believe that they are victims, who believe that government has a responsibility to care for them, who believe that they are entitled to health care, to food, to housing, to you name it. But that's an entitlement, and government should give it to them. And they will vote for this President no matter what.
Delegates, I accept your nomination for President of the United States. You didn't elect me to tell you what you wanted to hear. You elected me to tell you the truth. Our problems can be solved. Our challenges can be met. The path we offer may be harder, but it leads to a better place. And I'm asking you to choose that future. I'm asking you to rally around a set of goals for your country. Goals in manufacturing, energy, education, national security, and the deficit. Real, achievable plans that will lead to new jobs, more opportunity, and rebuild this economy on a stronger foundation. That's what we can do in the next 4 years, and that is why I am running for a second term as President of the United States.
We're closing in on the first results in the battle for the White House.
It is going to be an exciting night, and how close it will be.
And CNN projects President Obama will carry Vermont. CNN projects Mitt Romney will carry Kentucky. Right now on the race to 270, Mitt Romney has 8 electoral votes based on our projection, 3 Vermont for the president.
I want to show you a little place in Indiana. Vigo County, 1.7% of the population. Only twice since 1888 has Vigo County been wrong in picking a president. Why? Good question. But since the 1950s, this county has been right. Whoop, it's filling in blue at the moment. Look at that.
Both presidential campaigns know it's crunch time. Here is the line. Here is the clock. Polls close here in about 5 minutes. A fresh wave of voters just came in. Right now, 8 p.m. on the East Coast, Connecticut, Delaware, District of Columbia, Washington, D.C., home state of Illinois, a big prize, 20 electoral votes. Right now, the president has 64 electoral votes in his corner. We project Mitt Romney has 40 in his corner. Kansas will be won by Mitt Romney. Nebraska, North Dakota, another 3 electoral votes. Look at this, Texas. 38 electoral votes all going for Mitt Romney in Michigan. The home of the U.S. auto industry will be in the president's column. 16 electoral votes. The president picks up all 29 electoral votes in New York State, and he does in New Jersey as well. CNN projects that Barack Obama will be re-elected president of the United States. He will remain in the White House for another 4 years because we project he will carry the state of Ohio. By carrying Ohio, he wins re-election. The president of the United States defeats Mitt Romney in this session.
So right now with the...
Let me get the internet up.
There's only 3 counties missing right now.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to make an announcement that referendum 74 passed. It was approved.